Right. Hi, everyone. Okay, it's me, Max, right? I'm here. My hair looks a mess. I'm looking a mess. I'm coming to you all because today is the hair tutorial. I get a lot of questions about my hair, about what I do to maintain it, and about like my overall hair routine. So today is actually the last day I'm going to have this hair. And you know, it's scary and I'm definitely nervous. But it's something I've wanted for so long, and it's a change that I just feel like I need in my life. I feel like I've just been going through a lot the last couple of months. And if you follow me on my other social media, you might know vaguely like what's going on. And I don't know if I'll ever make an update video, because I just don't know if it's really a big enough deal. It's not like an announcement or anything like I have to make. It's just like, just a lot of stuff. So I just feel like I need like to just get rid of everything and like start fresh and new. This is like the last hair video with this hair. I didn't do a lot of hair videos, but this is going to be like my hair routine, because after today, it's over. This hair routine is not gonna be anymore. So I was always like waiting to do this video until like I found like the perfect products and I found the perfect system. And I, you know, I have products that are working for me now, but like it's maybe not the best things. I wanted to try more stuff, but it is what it is. But I'm chopping all this off. I'm chopping all of this off. It's been 4 or 5 years since I started growing out my hair, and I'm ready for a change. So today is literally gonna be like everything. It's gonna be answering everybody's questions about my hair. It's going to be showing you all my routine of me doing my hair. So if you want product suggestions, I will give you all of the information. And I just figured like this is like I need to do this just because I'm not gonna have long hair anymore. So I'll obviously like make a video showing off my new hair when I get it done. Meaning like Instagram, and you see my stories and stuff, you know like what I'm going to be getting done. But I'm not gonna say it in this video. Like, go follow my social media if you wanna know ahead of time. But yeah, so without further ado, like let's get into this. Alright, so first I'm going to be brushing my hair out. Just some like information about my upkeep with my hair. Basically, I wash it once a week. Usually it's on a Sunday or a Monday. Back when I was working, now it's just like whenever. My hair is like looking pretty greasy right now. I haven't had to go out really at all. So I just like haven't really cared about my hair the last couple of weeks. Now that my hair is brushed out, I just do that so that when I'm washing it, just makes like life so much easier. My hair, I use dry shampoo. Batiste is definitely my favorite dry shampoo that I use. And that's just how I maintain it for a week. I mean, everybody's like, oh my gosh, my hair gets so oily. Like I could never go a week without shampooing, but like, it's like my hair does too. I just use a lot of dry shampoo. Like you could totally do it. And I mainly do that for my color upkeep. I think like, you know, a lot of people say like, oh, preserve the natural oils. I mean, I really don't. I mean, that is a thing, but I think every other day, every 3 days, is good. Every week, I don't necessarily think is actually that good for your hair. Just like for my personal experience, I feel like it actually like makes my hair drier because I'm not conditioning as often. I'm only conditioning once a week. It's not like I shampoo once a week, but I condition more often. Like no, and I do use oils and stuff, and I'll go through that when I'm styling my hair. I do use those in my hair, but it's just not the same sort of moisture that I'd be getting if I were actually using conditioner. So, and again, that's like one of those things that like maybe I could have just like found better products, but it's just like something to keep in mind that if you are planning on washing your hair less often, or I should say if you're planning on conditioning your hair less often, find products for styling your hair that are gonna bring moisture back into your hair if you find that your hair is getting dry. My hair type is extremely coarse and it's extremely thick. in debt. So I have a lot of hair, and my hair itself, like the strands themselves, are coarse. So I do find that products suck, like my hair sucks up products, sucks up moisture. I do get oily on the scalp, but it's just, it can get very, very dry. My hair is like wavy, but like not really. My hair texture is like really, really weird. I know when I did my last hair update video, like I never actually had styled my hair. Like I never styled my hair back then. Nowadays I cannot like not style my hair because I just think I look horrible. Like my hair is so frizzy and poofy. I don't know. I don't know if it's like the dye that did that or if my mind just never realized how frizzy it was back then, and now I just know, working with hair now, that like my hair is so fucking frizzy. Yeah, so now that my hair is all brushed out, I'm going to go to the shower and wash my hair. Okay, so I just tried to obviously film, you know, my shower routine. Like while I was in there, I wanted to show you like me actually using the products just because I thought that would be more interesting. I love the sound of like the cicadas outside or whatever, but obviously I was just trying to, you know, do that. But obviously you could see that my camera just kept fogging up and I didn't know what to do. I don't know how YouTubers film their shower routines and they don't have their cameras fog up. Yeah, it was like really bad. So, and I couldn't figure out like how to stop that. So I'm going to just go through all of the products that I like to use when I'm styling my hair. This is my hair naturally out of the shower, air dried, no product in it other than what I used when I was in the shower. I usually do put product in it. I forgot. Like I honestly forgot. So not that I've really found products that make a huge difference, but you know, this is my hair. This is what it looks like. So basically the way that I wash my hair is like really weird and excessive. I use 3 different shampoos. So for my roots, basically I use the Paul Mitchell Instant. There's a lot of noise going on. So I use a lot of Paul Mitchell products because that is the product line that I was trained under when I was in school. So for my shampoo, I use the Paul Mitchell Instant Moisture Shampoo. What I do with this shampoo is I obviously put it in my hands and I just shampoo my roots basically. So I shampoo my roots using the Instant Moisture one. And then for my ends, I use Paul Mitchell's Shampoo 2. Now this shampoo is a clarifying shampoo. In the Paul Mitchell range, they have shampoo 1, 2, and 3, and 3 is like the most clarifying one, and I kinda wanna try that one out. This one's shampoo 2, and it's still a really powerful clarifying shampoo. I think that shampoo 3 would maybe be a little bit better suited to what I was using it for, but basically what I use with this is you really should never use a clarifying shampoo if you have colored hair, because it's going to clarify your hair. It's going to remove whatever's on your hair. And if your hair has been dyed, it's going to be removing the dye. I use this only on my ends because my ends, and I don't know if it's going to show up on camera, but my ends, and they look pretty similar in color, and I really don't know if it's going to show up on camera. My ends are just a little darker than the top of my hair, and it's not anything really noticeable. It's nothing that you notice, you know, if my hair's down, if you see all my hair down, it's not noticeable. But I just do that because I think there's just like all the hair dye collects at the bottom when I wash it. It all collects at the bottom. And so I just use this to kind of prevent that, to kind of clear out the ends to make them just a little bit brighter. I mean, it makes them a little bit lighter, but mainly it just removes that kind of like muddiness that happens at the bottom. And I don't really know why that happens. I don't know if it would happen with any hair dye. I use Joico, and so I don't know if it's the Joico dye, if that's the issue, but I just use that to do that. I've also been using it more recently just on my hair in general because I've been trying to fade it. It has been 3 months, y'all. 3 months since I got my hair dyed. I have not reapplied any dye on my hair, and this is the yellow. I mean, it's still bright. It's still fucking yellow. I'm just trying my best, like, not to use bleach to get rid of this color. I will see people who use, you know, semi-permanent, like, fashion colors, and they wash out, you know, to, like, a nice blonde color, and this literally, it's like, it barely has faded since I got it done. Sorry, I have a mirror there. It's barely faded since I got it done. So, I have been using the clarifying shampoo more to try to fade my color in anticipation for wanting to try different colors. But yeah. So then after I've used these two shampoos, once again, I use the moisture one on my, I mean, I use it mainly on my roots, but then I bring it down to the ends and then I rinse that out and then I put the shampoo to just on my ends and really, you know, scrub it in and work that in. I haven't been using this as much because, like I said, I've been trying to kind of fade my color a little bit. However, I would normally go in with the Viral Extreme Yellow Color Wash shampoo. So this is a cleanse plus color deposit technology. I can't say I've noticed a personal difference in my hair color fading from using this. Before I started using this, my hair looked the same, it faded the same. But I can't really vouch for it because I also shampoo with these. So like, I can't say, oh, if you only shampooed with this, maybe like my hair would be a way brighter yellow. I mainly use this because I'm not gonna be able to get it on camera, but I will try to take a picture or something. But it literally looks like there's like sparkles in here. It makes your hair like extremely shiny and it has like this radiant like glow to it. It just like, I can't say it makes my hair brighter yellow, but it does add a little bit extra shine. And I think this is a really good shampoo, and if you wanted to use it on its own, I'm using these shampoos because I need like the moisture and I need the clarifying aspects of them. However, I think this would be a really great shampoo if you just use it on your own. And I'm pretty sure they have colored conditioners as well. So what I do with this is I treat it like it's a purple shampoo. When I learned at the salon that I used to work at, what I learned how to apply purple shampoo is that you put it on your hands and you don't rub it together. You don't get in your scalp and go like this. You go in, you put the shampoo in your hands, you know, you go like that, so it's on both hands, you don't froth it up or whatever, and then you just go and you just place it. You just place it on the hair like so. You can go in and you go like that and you just kind of run it through your hair, but you don't go like scrubbing it. And what that's gonna do is it's gonna allow the product to sit on the hair and allow the hair to actually absorb it. And I let this sit on my hair for like a little bit, like a minute, a few minutes, just to try to get the most out of the color. And then finally, what I'll do for my conditioner is I use the Moroccan Oil Intense Hydrating Mask. And this is for hydration specifically. And this one is really good for medium to thick hair. Like I said, my hair is extremely, extremely, extremely thick and coarse, and it sucks up moisture. So this is an intense hair mask. It is pretty expensive. With my professional discount, it's still like $20, but it's definitely worth it. It smells, oh my gosh. Oh, I love the smell of the Moroccan oil products. The salon that I was working at, they mainly used Moroccan oil products for styling, and oh my gosh, they just all smell really good and they work really, really, really good. They do have other ones for different hair types. Just get the one for your hair type. If your hair is not medium to thick, I think this would be too much, but they do have one that is a little bit lighter. So this is just a really great product. And I put this in my hair, and depending on if I have the time, sometimes I will leave this on for a few hours. I put my hair in a plastic cap so it kind of stays, you know, moist, or I'll just leave it on and I'll like do the rest of my shower stuff and then rinse this out. But either way, it's a really great conditioner. So then I get out of the shower, right? What do I do? Normally I will go in with the Paul Mitchell Super Skinny Serum, and I'm gonna do this now since I haven't done it. I'm gonna do 2 pumps. I would normally not use that much. If you have like a regular density hair, I would just say go in with 1 pump. My hair is so thick that, you know, I use a lot. Also, if your hair is wet, I usually suggest like go, like, you know, doing 2 pumps maybe, because I don't know, something about wet hair, it like seems to soak up the product a lot more. And then when you go in with a hair dryer, it like, you know, most of the product ends up evaporating. So if you're doing it on dry, I say do less. I really like this product for like general, getting like general smoothness. I don't think it's the absolute like best smoothing product on the market, but it definitely is good. It does the job. Is when, and I would like suggest not to like bring it too far up. I just don't put it on the roots. However, I find as long as you're not going in with too much product, it's not gonna like really leave your hair being really oily, because it's not an oil, it's a serum. I think it's like alcohol based, which, you know, I kind of hesitant about that because I don't like that it's like a lot of alcohol. But if you have, this is like a really good product where, and I can look at my hair and it already kind of looks a little bit less poofy. This is a really good product as well that I'll use on maybe day 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 where my hair is starting to look a little bit poofy and I just need to bring it down. It's really good for that. If you have extreme frizz like me, then you needed something a little bit more heavy duty. But the thing about my frizz is like after day 1 goes by, like 24 hours, 48 hours goes by, my hair's not really frizzy anymore. So, you know, this is really good for combating that just general frizz that will come up. So then after I go in with that, I will go in with some Moroccan argan oil. This is from The Ordinary. This is The Ordinary's 100% organic cold pressed Moroccan argan oil. And I used to literally like despise the smell of this. I have kind of grown to start to enjoy it. I don't know, I'll just do, it's a lot, but I used to like literally like hate the smell of this, because the thing about this is it's organic Moroccan oil. That's what it is. That's the only ingredient. So there's no fillers, there's no additives, there's nothing that makes it anything more than just argan oil. So, you know, there's no scents, there's nothing. It just, it's not the best smell, but it doesn't really stay on your hair too much. I've never, you know, heard complaints about like the scent of my hair. I feel like it disappears pretty quickly. So I've never really noticed anything like that, but I just put that on the ends of my hair just to add some general more smoothness. And also this is something that I will usually use on my hair every morning when I wake up. I'll just run this through my ends just to keep the moisture balanced in my hair. Now onto the styling slash Q&A part of the tutorial. So let me show you how I would blow dry my hair if I were blow drying it. My hair just has a little bit of dampness, so I'm just gonna get rid of that. And then, am I gonna curl it? Like, I'm like, should I curl it? Let me blow dry it and see how straight I can get it and smooth. And if I can't, then I'll curl it. But I'm just like, I'm getting my hair cut tomorrow, so I don't really know if I want to bother, but I will still go through and show you how I would curl my hair. I just don't know if I'm gonna take the time, because it does take me a while to curl my hair. So I hope you guys can understand that. So if I were blow drying my hair on like damp hair, I would go in with a cream or a liquid heat protectant. This is the one I have. It is the Tresemme Heat Tamer. It just looks like this. I really like this thing. I think it smells really good and it's a nice heat protectant. So if my hair was wet, I would use this. However, I'm not gonna use this because my hair is basically dry and spraying this on my hair is just gonna make my hair wetter than it already is. Another really good one, if you wanna use a more professional product, I really like the Paul Mitchell Neuroline. Personally, they have a heat protectant primer is what they call it. And it's just like, it's really sleek and nice and it smells really good. What I'm going to be using, because my hair is basically dry, is I'm going to be using the Paul Mitchell Neuro Protect. And what this is it is an aerosol heat protectant. And first of all, it smells really good. And what I really like about this is a lot of the times heat protectants do come in this liquid form. And I just don't like this because this makes my hair damp. I don't like that. What I like about this is not a heat protectant hairspray. So it doesn't leave your hair feeling like crunchy or anything. Although, you know, there's a time and a place for heat protectant hairsprays. But this is just an aerosol heat protectant. It doesn't make my hair feel crunchy. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna spray the fuck out of my hair. And I love the smell of that stuff. So like my blow drying is going to be a little bit differently just because like I'm not going from perfectly like wet. However, the two brushes that I would use when blow drying my personal hair, and it's different when I do clients, but my personal hair is I like using both of these. This is the Olivia Garden, I believe. Yeah, it's the Nanothermic by Olivia Garden ceramic ion round brush. And does it say which size this one is? I don't know. This one is like medium. It's not like huge. this is like a professional staple, and if I can find it on Amazon, I will try to list like all the legit websites where you can buy these products down below. A lot of professionals use this. I was just watching a Guy Tang video, and he uses this, and most of the salons I go to, they use this brand of round brush. They're just really good. It's just, it's something to do with like how the heat can circulate through. These get really, really hot, which is what you want. I mean, it helps you heat up the hair and get it smoother. And I really like using this as well, just mainly for this purpose of picking up the hair and bringing it out. And like, I kind of go through and try to smooth everything out with this. And I use this to kind of just rough dry most of the stuff. Oh, and for my blow dryer, I use the, okay, people say Babyliss. I think it's Bay Bliss. But this is like their yellow one. It's kind of, it's like their most powerful one. These are expensive. This is like $300, I'm pretty sure. And that is like with my professional discount. So, I mean, these things are expensive, but they're really, really nice and they're really powerful. Okay, so I am gonna look in the mirror right here, but I'm gonna explain what I'm doing. I am first parting it down the middle. I've recently been liking parting my hair down the middle, so I'm gonna just do a middle part, quick, easy, simple. These are the Color Track, I think they're called like crocodile ones. I really like them because they are rubberized, so they just grip the hair a little bit better. They're a little bit more expensive. I think it's like $8 for a pack of four, but I do really like them. It takes me a lot longer to blow dry my own hair than if I were blow drying someone else's. Cause like when I'm blow drying someone else's, I'm like, okay. It's like, I don't have to like put something down, grab the hair, re-put it. I can just keep going. When I do it on my own, I have to like constantly like re-grab my hair. It's just, I'm still not really together. But I'm going to put this on the highest heat and the highest mode. So I'm not gonna be able to talk, but I might voice over it maybe. I'm not sure, we'll see. But I'm just gonna, you can just see what I'm doing. So that is like literally all that I'm doing is I'm just taking the round brush and I am just kind of with this hand twisting it as I go down just to keep tension on the hair. You want the hair to have tension. It's going to help it dry faster, I promise. And you just keep rotating it so it keeps that tension. And then I'm going to take the blow dryer and just, you know, whatever is easiest for you. For me, it's easiest for me to hold it like this, like at the nozzle part. It's easier for me to get in there. For me, it's just, it messes with my mind having to hold it there. It's so much easier for me to like do that. And yeah, so I'm just going in and smoothing it, and it's gonna take like 2 seconds because my hair's already dry. You know what I mean? So I'm literally just doing this so I can smooth it out and I don't have to go in with a straightener. So I would literally just repeat that step all the way up my head to get a really like smooth result, all right? Another tip when you are blow drying your hair is to try to make sure that the nozzle is always going down. It's always pointed in a downward direction, because if your hair is going like this, your hair's drying up like that, and it's going to make all the little pieces, all the little breakage pieces fly up and make your hair look so much frizzier. So just try to always make it so that it's down. And a nice tip to keep a lot of volume at the root, if you're like trying to really give yourself a nice professional blowout, is take the round brush and twist it at the root and really, really get it in there. And then take the blow dryer and go in and like make sure that it's angled kind of upwards and go in like that with the blow dryer. I don't know if this is making any sense, but like go in with that and then, you know, bring it down. But that's gonna give you a lot of volume. I honestly think I'm gonna curl my hair, so I'm actually not gonna go through and blow dry all my hair to be honest, if you know you are going to be styling your hair with a heat tool, don't bother going through and getting it really smooth, because that's just a waste of your time. So I'm gonna show you how to kind of rough dry your hair so that you can go in with heat tools and style it. So I am going to be going in with this brush, and I'm just gonna show you guys, and I might do a voiceover. Remember how I said, oh yeah, like make sure, you know, the blow dryer is going in one direction so you don't get it so frizzy. And, you know, sometimes we don't want to listen to that rule, because when we're just getting it rough dry, who really cares? But I mean, you can even see from the beginning of the video to now, my hair is way smoother than what it was. It's got a way more even texture. So that's even something like, if I don't have the time to go through and really smooth out my hair, I still can do that and quickly, you know, I have this weird texture, which maybe you could see in the beginning, but it's like that. Like, I don't know. It's like really like crimpy and it's not a wave. It's just a weird texture. And it's right here. It's not on the side. It's just on this side. So, you know, that kind of helps fix that and everything. All right, so I am gonna curl my hair for you guys just so I can show you all how I do that and how I get the nice curl that I usually am wearing. I usually use a 1.25 inch curling iron. I think this is the most universal size. If I can only ever bring one, I always bring this one, because you can use this on short hair or long hair, and it usually gives a pretty nice loose wave look to the hair. All of my curling irons, I have removed the clamp, so there were just wands, because I just can't fucking do the clamp. I'm sorry. So once again, I'm going to go in with the heat protectant from Paul Mitchell, and I'm gonna spray this, because you can't go wrong with too much heat protectant, right? My tip for people with long hair who are trying to figure out how to curl their hair is throw it all back. Just throw it back and then just take pieces. Take a piece, curl it. Take a piece, curl it, and let all the curled ones fall forward, and then you'll just get to the back. So I will show you all. But yeah, that is my tip, because I don't know, my issue, why I used to like never curl my hair, like why I couldn't, is because I would always just get lost. Like, I don't know, am I crazy? I would always just get lost in my hair. Alrighty, so like I said, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna throw my hair all back. I'm just gonna get to curling. It's, I don't know. I don't wanna say it's pretty simple, because I never understood it, but you literally, I'm just taking like a little piece of hair and holding it like this, and wrapping it around. And you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's all. And oh, the temperature I have it on is 450. So, you know, I feel like it's really scary to go in with extreme heat. Oh, 450 degrees, like that's so scary. But I don't know, the reality is I'm not, because I'm having it on a higher temperature, I don't hold it on my hair for nearly as long. Whereas like what, cause I used to be like so scared of damaging my hair through heat. And so I would always be like, I would always do like a really low setting, like 2 something. And I found I was sitting there and I was like, oh, like I'm holding my fucking hair on this iron for like 30 seconds. And like, that's not good for your hair, because it's sitting on the heat longer. Honestly, I don't know if this is true, but I've just heard a lot of professionals say that it's actually better to do a higher heat so that your hair's not sitting on the heat for longer. I heard that's better for your hair. So I don't have any, you know, science to back that up. However, that's just what I've heard. So what I usually do is I'll like curl the first like bang section all going back, and then I'll start alternating them just kind of like randomly, sporadically. I get like, sometimes I'll get like lost or confused, and I will be like, oh, did I go forward, backward? It doesn't matter, you know? So my hair is insanely thick, and like sometimes I'll curl like clients' hair and their hair is like nice and thin, and it's just, oh, you can take like three sections in their hair and curl their entire head, and I'm like, can't relate. Like, that will never be me, cries, because I don't know. I wish my hair was thin, and obviously like leave the ends out. If I have like a special event to go to, like if I want to look like my hair look really, really nice, I'll go through and I'll curl my hair, and I'll do a curl, and then I'll take a straightener and I will straighten out that last bump in the curl. And what that'll do is it'll give like a way more beachier, you know, it just makes your hair look expensive and nice. And I'll throw up a picture of what that looks like when I do that on my hair. And I really like how that looks. It's just more time consuming because you have to use multiple tools. So I don't do that as often. So I asked on Instagram if people could leave questions, if anybody had any questions about my hair. So the first person asks, I don't know if I should say people's names, Mercury Pine, Diego Sands, that's my friend, said, how do you manage to pull off such a strong hair color, hair goals, to be honest? First of all, thank you so much. You know, it's really like, as stupid as it sounds, maybe as cliche, like, oh, this is what everybody says, but really it's about like having that confidence. If you tell yourself that you're gonna pull off this hair color, then you're gonna pull it off. Like, all you have to do is not feel insecure. Don't hide behind your hair. Don't let your hair speak for you. Like, don't let your hair like wear you. Like, wear your hair and just like, it's just, you know, wear it like it's fucking normal to you. And then that's how you pull it off, you know? Like, I really believe that anybody can really pull off anything if they just, you know, it's also about like your style. I think you have to find the right style that fits with your hair, or find the right hair that fits with your style, you know, find something that suits you really, you know? A lot of the times in my fashion, I do wear a lot of bright colors. And so I feel like it just suits it. Like, when I always dress to match my hair. I always have in mind like, oh, how will this hair color, or how will this outfit look with, you know, my yellow hair? And I think that's a big thing. It's about like, you know, your overall image, working with it as well. But it's just really about like having that confidence. I mean, that's the way that you pull it off. I hear from so many people all the time, like, oh, I wish I could pull off a color like that. And like, you really could. You could. I promise you, you could. I promise. I know you guys can. Just believe in yourself. Believe in the fact that you guys can do that. Like, and it's so stupid. Like, I mean, yeah, obviously there's certain colors that like clash with certain skin tones. But I don't know. But I really believe like you can find it in the basics of color. You can find a red color that's gonna suit your skin tone. You can find a yellow color that suits your skin tone. You can find a green color that suits your skin tone. Maybe it's not the shade of green you want. You can find something that suits you. So yeah. So when I start to get towards the back, I'll just go through and section it in half. It doesn't have to be like precise. I just kind of do this so I can signal myself when to move to the other side. And definitely like when you're curling your hair, you have to kind of like contort your arms a little bit so that, you know, you can reach in the back specifically. Like, you just have to kind of find your rhythm, find, you know, it is about practice. And, you know, my biggest tip is like, don't actually curl your hair. Like, go through and take your curling iron when it's not on and just go through as if you're curling your hair until you feel comfortable with how your arms are gonna be. Like, I just feel like that was my hardest thing, was like having my arms feel comfortable, having everything just not feel like so weird. So that side is all done, and I'll brush through it. I'll curl other pieces that are looking a little bit straighter, but that's like essentially how I curl my hair. Yeah. normally I would like hairspray it and do all of that, but because I am getting my hair done tomorrow, I just don't want to have as much product build up. And I might go in with a sea salt spray also as well, just to break these curls up a little bit, but this is it. Ugh, I can't even get all my hair in the frame. So like I said, if you guys have any questions about my hair, anything that you'd want to see from me, just let me know and I will let y'all know. And I will let y'all know I'm 100% transparent, so I'm not going to hide anything from you guys. So if you have any other hair questions, just ask them down below and I will make sure to answer them. And yeah, so my name is Maxi Rainbow. I will see you guys later. Goodbye. Mwah.